kids. Missionary Mark here again with you. The video you're watching right here is on the island of Manuvalu in the village of Nambawalu. This happened just shortly after Cyclone Yasa passed through. You can see these kids, they're standing outside. We have no electricity. That's my generator that's providing the power for us to have the lighting and the music there. And as you can see, these kids were not going to allow a cyclone to stop their song. They were just going to praise God. So today, we want to take a look at how we are helping, how you are going to help, and how we together can help kids just like this in Fiji to be able to have times of praise and worship, go to Sunday school and children's church in buildings instead of having to be outside and do their Sunday school and children's church outside. Tell you what, let's take a drive right now to the village of Lekutu. That's right. We're going to take a drive to Lekutu. Lekutu was hit by Cyclone Yasa, and as you can see, the trees are so many of all knocked down, and the ones that are left standing, it looks like it's wintertime, no leaves on it, because if you have winds of 150 miles an hour hitting you, it's just going to rip the leaves right off you. So imagine driving down the road as fast as you've ever gone in a car before, and then go twice as fast as that, and that's about 150 miles an hour. That's how fast those winds were blowing. Well, as you can see, the Lekutu Elementary School here, the Lekutu Elementary School was completely, you can see it's just destroyed and knocked down. Terrible what happened to the elementary school. Now let's take a look at the church as we drive into the church's parking lot here. And wow, praise God, there is a church. It's actually still standing.
Now, because God lives, if we fall, we'll stand up again.
Most of the church is still standing. There's a couple places where you can see the wall started caving in there. What we're wanting to do is raise money so churches like this can repair their structures so that the children will be able to worship outside of the rain.
All the people there were standing, they were scared, just looking around for the children.
Yeah, yeah.
They didn't care for the children at night. All the men.
Another place I want to take you to is called Ndraketi. I had heard about Ndraketi. I heard that the winds were so bad there that even in the hurricane or cyclone shelters, that the people had to run underneath and hide under the floors in the crawl spaces, because even in these shelters, the roofs were ripped off. And so as we were driving to Ndraketi, I saw this one place and I said, wow, that looks really terrible. What happened there? And the pastor said, that's the Assemblies of God Church at Ndraketi. It's like, oh my goodness, let's stop. And so we stopped there, got out, and the pastor and his wife were home. We went in their house, and you can see that the roof of their house, a lot of it was torn off, and half of it was like laying in the backyard all over the ground. But I talked with the pastor, and I was like, oh, this is terrible, pastor. What happened? And you know what the pastor said? He said, hey, you know what? We were wanting to expand anyways. No, this is just the Lord helping us out in the teardown process. Huh, can you believe that? Praise the Lord. So, but even so, places like this, we want to help them rebuild. This is where they were doing their Sunday school. This is where they were doing their children's church. So we want to do that, help these guys out. So there you have it for today, kids. Thank you so much for helping us. You know what? If you were to ever have something bad like that happen to your house where, you know, a bad storm or something came and knocked down your roof or your church's roof, I just pray that just like you're helping us today, that people would respond someday to you and help you out as well. See you. We'll be right back.